and soaked in our youth. Thought we was running shit till we lost the sole of our shoe.
I knew it.
Yeah.
He said we was running until we lost the sole of our shoe, but proof died. Boy, Big Holla. Y'all already know what's going on. We here. Listen, I'm here with the boy.
What's good, YouTube? It is your boy, Snapper Jones, man, with my boy, Big Holla. We got some fire for y'all. Yippee.
Look, y'all been in the comments telling me to react to Eminem, so I'm going to keep doing it. You know what I'm saying? Thanks. So, if y'all seen the boy, Lucid, the guy who was in my last video, he actually went to react to this song on his channel. It's called Stepping Stones.
Yeah.
I was in the background playing the game. Now, I kind of heard the song, but not too much. I kind of know the gist of the song. It's about Eminem and D12, but I didn't really listen to it. And he for sure ain't heard it.
Yeah, I've been on the road. Yeah, I've been on the road, man. I've been on the road. If any of y'all like sneakers, any of y'all like fashion, sneakers, comedy, check out my channel. My boy gonna link it down below in that description. Yeah, feel me? We grinding trying to hit that 10K, so check me out, man.
It's gonna pop up somewhere up there, you know what I'm saying? It's gonna say suggested. Okay, boom. Okay. But look, this song is called Stepping Stone, so let's just, you know, hop into it. Venom's coming next. I seen those comments, so we're gonna do Venom also.
Y'all see that? Y'all comment, he get them to you.
Hey, look.
I wanna hear some shots.
Oh no! I don't think this song is about shots.
Oh, so it's just about like
Venom might be, but this one is about, you'll see.
Okay.
It's 2002. Everything was totally new. We were globally huge, watching sales go through the roof. Mm. We wrote when we viewed it. Onion Avenue soldiers included, a multitude of homies who were pounced for no good excuse.
See, he's talking about him and like him and D12.
Okay.
They were like blowing up with each other. But I think this song is about the falling out of them.
Okay, so it's like the story of D12.
Of D12 from the beginning to now.
I love Eminem's storyline. Like, Dear Stan is like one of my favorite songs of all time. Yeah, for sure.
It's definitely top five for me.
Oh, yeah.
I knew it.
Yeah.
He said we was running until we lost the sole of our shoe, but proof died.
Got it. That's the soul.
He was the soul of the shoe.
I like that. Yeah. That's dope.
Let's go.
I like that a lot.
So I wasn't in no condition to be coaching us through. Everyone tried to go solo, really nobody blew. I was hoping they do, so I ain't have to shoulder the crew. The cameras put everyone in position so that they knew how to stand on their own. And I don't want to open up wounds.
See, okay,
yeah,
so he's basically saying
that's
like
real.
His thing was, I didn't want to endure the brunt of carrying D12.
Yeah, so he was hoping people went good
up
solo, so he didn't have to carry the burden of making sure everybody was,
yeah,
because he was going through his own issues, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, dealing with it, because like after Proof died, he came out with Soldier was on Encore.
That was a good song though. That was fire.
And he had a lot of stuff going. I'm pretty sure there was some stuff going on with Kim in regards to Haley back then, because I think that's the same album. No, that was the Eminem show. Okay, but anyway, yeah, let's hop back into the song. So I think he's about to go in depth a little bit more.
That sold of the shoe, that hit me, you know what I'm saying?
I just noticed the booth was gone when we go in the booth, because the truth is the moment the booth died, so it's the
truth.
I see why this is a lot of people's favorite song. This is like, it's something, you know what I'm saying? You listen to it with some headphones.
Yeah, facts.
Them back, man.
Yeah.
Them back on dog. Down below, M back if y'all rocking with this.
Yeah, if you think M is back, I think he never left, because I know that's about to be the hate comment for what you said. I done seen it happen before.
Hey, look, all my Eminem stands out there, I love M. I just feel like, as of late, I haven't been hearing nothing like this, that's all.
Yeah, this album is definitely probably top three of his albums.
I go with that,
because
the LP was crazy, of course.
Facts.
Hey.
From it, I pray that I don't fall. Cause on the way back down, I may end up running back.
You feel that, though, you know what I'm saying?
That's fight. Listen, he said, on my way up, I have to make amends because I might see y'all back on my way down.
Mm.
And you know how they say the same attention people give you on their way up is the same attention people are gonna give them
absolutely
on their way down.
Yeah.
That's fire.
That's real.
push you all is my stepping stones. And it's bothered me since. And the farther we drift apart, the more awkward it gets. The more time goes by, the more life happens. And we gotta be men. We got responsibilities. Plus, we don't say how we feel. And I feel like this is what got us in the debacle we're in. Man, what you got to
get in. Them is a word.
Yeah, you ever heard the song, How Come? We don't even no more. And we,
No.
How come? We don't even talk no more. I don't even feel the same love when we hug no more. I heard through the grapevine we even beefing now. After all the years we've been. So that was like their reunion song.
Okay.
So basically he's saying like, we never ever, like even though we got cool again, we never talked our stuff out.
You know? Oh, so they never really got closure on the old issues.
Yeah.
They just kind of got back together and tried
and
to pick
like,
it up.
Oh yeah, you my dude. So,
okay.
Yeah.
That's important,
but
man.
It's almost as if sometimes we're not even friends, which reminded me this. Rockstar was the shit. Y'all could have got you a hit without me on the shit. If you put D12 on it, wish I could have did. Water tried talking you into coming up off, but I know it wasn't my fault, but part of it probably is. I think all of the trips
that I'm trying to, who is he? He said the song Rockstar would have been a hit if y'all would have put D12 on it instead of me. I wish I would have never talked y'all out of giving me the song.
Yeah.
I don't know what song that is. Maybe it's in reference to like...
If y'all know what song it is, comment down below. Because I'm not sure what it is.
Yeah, I never heard the song.
But what I do know is M Flow.
Like, it's ridiculous.
It's crazy. It's crazy.
For sure.
BT and the rappers, I wish that we would apologize quick. Maybe y'all could have clicked and got you some features. But that's water under the bridge. But I'm washing my sins in it to my conscience.
Washing my sins in the water under the bridge. That's real. That's real.
All right, look, this is the chorus. We're going to skip ahead because I'm not even going to lie to y'all right now. My camera light blinking. So we're going, you know what I'm saying?
Come on, M.
Partying in. Never thought the party would end. 1 minute your body and shit, but then your audience splits. You can already sense the climate is starting to shift. To these kids, you no longer exist. Went from raining cats and dogs in this bitch to tiny drops, little trips. And by the time your reign is over, you'll hardly be missed.
By the time your rain is over, you hardly
be missed. But after it rains, it'll be missed on the ground. Like
come
coming
on.
From the...
Come on.
Yo.
Come on. That's
when the
bar.
Sun come back, bro. That's
you
right after
missed.
Your rain. But it was raining cats and dogs is an analogy to like raining a lot. But we're going to hop back.
That's a bar.
You start thinking of all the artists you get. All the carnage you left. Just the kind of karma you get. But turning your fucking back on busy cannaver and sweet. A Freudian slip. Subconsciously, I honestly wish. I ain't feel so much guilt.
Feel that, man. Okay.
See, like what he said is like basically like it's kind of hard for me to believe y'all don't feel some type of way about it.
Yeah.
And like I want to talk it out with y'all to make sure that's how y'all, because there's some things I've done in my life or situations I've had with people where I know like they might feel some type of way, but we never talked about it.
And that really don't help shit. You know
what I mean? But that's why people just need to sit down and talk. So this is him's, you know, his thing.
That's real though.
So yeah, he's basically saying like, look, I really support y'all. I mess with y'all.
I love
like,
you.
I will, I will love y'all to the day I die, but I just wasn't built for the position I was put in.
Yeah, basically, you know what I'm saying? For all that pressure to be on me to make everybody succeed, it was an immense pressure, basically, is what he was saying.
And
he didn't like it.
Bro, you could really feel that, I'm pretty sure. Because some people, they get on and they completely cut everybody off.
Yeah.
Like, he tried, but he just didn't have it in him.
Because I'm gonna be honest, like, I didn't know D12 was that nice until they went on Sway by themselves without him, and they killed it. Like, they killed it. But due to the songs that they were putting out, like, My Band and stuff like that, like, I didn't know how talented they were, like, individually. But
they were
pretty good, bro.
All right, look, we about to hop back into it. See, he said, I'm barely charting myself.
Yeah, I'm barely doing well myself. I'm going to do well for y'all.
See, Eminem the GOAT.
That's real, though.
Y'all like a stepping stone, though I ain't left no one behind. But we've been down every road, all we possibly can. I know we kept our hopes up, but the longer we spend living this lie that we live, the less is left for closure. So let's let this go. It's not goodbye to our friendship, but D12 is over.
Shit.
He said it's not goodbye to the friendship, but we can't...
We can't do the group no more, but we can always be brothers. Like, we can always, you know what I'm saying? That chemistry that we got as a group will never go anywhere.
Facts. But we about to... It's like 40 seconds left, so I'm pretty sure he's going to say something, so we're going to hop into that real quick.
I'm
wash away my sins. Oh, it looks like the chorus. Yeah, it basically just went
back into real. I can see why a lot of you guys chose that song to be reacted to, because a lot of realness was in that song, and it tell you a lot of stuff we never knew about M.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
So like, how he felt about it.
Right.
Yeah.
So if you was a real M fan, this is like new news to you. From his perspective, not just, you know what I'm saying, hearsay.
Yeah, so Tyler is the one in the comments that told me to react to this. This
Shout
was definitely
Ty.
Worth Tyler, you know what I'm saying?
Thanks.
To react to, you know.
Eminem is hard. Like, when you listen to Eminem, you gotta have that ugly face. You know what I'm saying? Could you just, you know what I'm saying? So we both like,
this is definitely probably gonna be one of my favorite songs. This is probably my favorite song.
When I check out the album, because I have not checked out the album, I just heard him in the Jordan track.
Yeah.
The single.
Alright, sorry guys, we couldn't give the rest of our synopsis. The battery actually died and it's still dead. So, y'all like, comment, subscribe, head over to our YouTube. The camera cut off. I charged it for about 5 minutes. So we can go ahead and hit y'all with this outro.
Thanks.
Y'all head over to Sniper Jones' channel. My guy got some crazy content. Listen,
thanks.
Your favorite vlogger. This is content.
You know what I'm
saying? You know what I'm saying? But listen, this song was fire.
Definitely was fire. I'm glad it's like one of the first songs I listened to, like singles off the track. I got me want to listen to the whole thing.
I'ma just say I'm never singing again after that.
Yes, it was bad.
But y'all like, comment, subscribe. It's your boy Big Holla.
And it's your boy Sniper Jones, boy. Appreciate y'all.
And we out of here.
Gay.
Thought this was my all, but it isn't. They would have blamed God, but I didn't. My whole team took it in stride. We ain't never took no pride. Our love for this game is the reason why we in it. They thought this was my all, but it isn't. They would have blamed God, but I didn't. My whole team took it in stride. We ain't never took no pride. Our love for this game is the reason why we in it. You never compromise and show no change, but we still about to blow no propane. I got these thoughts of suicide. Since these people want me dead, I'll take a bullet to the head like Cobain.